Again, you go down. Very easy for me. I'm very unfortunate. Now go get me some yoo-hoos and some plot wraps in honor of my victory.
I got next.
Nah, I don't play no charity games.
What, you afraid of the Irish hand?
Look, dog, I don't play no octagons, all right? There's no geritols on the court.
$50 says I kick your ass, salsa boy.
Let's go, fat man. I'll even give you first serve.
Comes the lightning. You ready, boy?
Listen, you fat bitch. Don't call me boy. It's very embarrassing. I smell like mothballs.
Serve it up.
Bring it. Serve it. Come on, serve it.
That's what I'm doing. You all right, Pops?
Enough to kick your ass, Julio.
Paco. My name is Paco.
Whatever.
You all right, Paco? Well, take it easy for a second.
Turn him up.
Paco, you all right? Hey, come on, Pops. Cut it out. Get up. Hey, Pops. Yo, call 911s. Somebody call the 911s.
He's happy he died on the court. He never should have been playing in this heat.
63 and 220 pounds. He shouldn't have been playing at all.
All right, quiet. Come on, quiet. All right, shut it.
We better get out there before Yonka breaks something.
I'm going to say something about my brother. John always talked about having a wake like this, you know, where family and friends came and got stinking drunk and told stupid stories about him. I already talked to a lot of you, so the stupid part's all taken care of, I guess. But I love my brother. He was a lot of things to a lot of people. He was a husband to his beautiful Gracie. He was a father to Henry and Kate. He was a boss in his own business.
He's probably raising a pint right now. Challenging the Lord Christ himself in that big handball court in the sky.
To John.
To John.
Sure.
Sorry, Sheila.
Why are we in my room?
It's not important where we are, Hank. Only that we're here together. Which leads me to why we're here together. You're the head of this household now. You are, Hank. Not me. I can't be because I'm the head of another household. My household.
I'm Charlie Doyle, Henry.
This is Charlie Doyle, Henry.
I'm sorry we had to meet under these circumstances. I am your father's attorney. There are some important decisions.
Mrs. Doyle has some important things he needs to talk to you about.
There's no easy way to put this, Henry, so I'm just going to be blunt. The family's broke. In fact, it's worse than that. There are substantial debts.
Yeah, well, I figured my dad wasn't too good with money, but he did have a life insurance policy, right?
Your father's life insurance company expressly warned him about participating in certain activities, such as handball, which they considered a health risk. He wasn't covered.
So there's no insurance money?
I'm afraid not. Sorry.
Well, what about the business?
Your father was the business. There are no assets there.
Are you going to work?
I switched shifts so I could be at the funeral. Look, at least the old man went down swinging.
It's great, Uncle Colin. I'm real proud.
Dean Swift?
Oh, hello, Henry. We're sorry to hear about your father.
Thank you. You know what? I can come back.
No, actually, I could use your help. Come. I just have to fix this one model for Miss Abel's class. Can you hold the vagina in place here?
Sure, I can do that.
While I put the ladder in. There you go. Sorry to see you leave, Henry. Your scores are beginning to improve.
Well, it should just be temporary.
Can you pass me the rectum? Thank you. Henry, this is an ovary. You should be able to recognize a rectum by now. You're better than that.
You're right. Is this it?
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's a rectum.
I want to complete my coursework as soon as possible. I just really need to make some money right now.
I understand, Henry. You have 2 years to make up the remaining classes.
I hope to do it as soon as I can.
Do you see the testicular self-examination model? You take care of yourself, Henry.
Thank you.
Well, I'll be pulling for you.
Help you?
I'm here to see George.
Okay. The name?
George.
No, buddy, not his name. I know his name. He's writing my paycheck. Your name?
Sorry, Henry O'Shea.
Mr. George, there's a Henry O'Shea in the lobby.
I'll be right there.
Okay. He's coming.
Great. You like working here?
O'Shea?
Yeah.
Yeah, hi. What?
What?
What are you looking at?
Nothing. I'm Henry.
Yeah, George. Come on, we'll take this down to my office.
First thing you need to know is you never go through that front door. The only time you're in the front is when you're in uniform. You got it?
Got it.
Got it? Look, kid. Your Uncle Colin and I, we go way back. I'm doing him a solid, giving you a job.
Okay, thank you, sir.
No. You save the sir crap for the tenants, all right? Me, my name's George, that's what you call me.
I know I look like a fighter, but I'm a real pussycat. Ask anybody. Go ahead, sit down. Yeah, just put that on the floor. So, what makes you think you're doorman material? Your Uncle Colin said that you wanted to be a nurse, but you couldn't hack it, right?
No, not exactly.
Look, I don't give a horse's tit about your past. Billy Donovan was a fruit. He worked there 15 years. You know, your past is your past. Your Uncle Colin says you're a good kid, so you're a good kid until you prove otherwise.
Okay, good, but,
save it for the shrink. Let's go over the rules. The most important rule, the golden rule, is, you wanna guess?
Treat other people like you wanna be treated?
Wrong, dead wrong. The most important rule is you never, ever let somebody in the building not supposed to be in.
Okay, of course.
Don't say of course. If it was of course, you'd get it right, right? Everybody, they think being a doorman is easy. It's not so easy. The devil's in the details, kid. You know, you gotta learn how to put out packages, learn people's names, you know? And what's the most important thing?
Don't let other people in that aren't supposed to get in.
Yeah, good. Don't forget that. No eating or sleeping in the lobby. Don't fraternize with the residents. They got better things to do than talk to you. You keep it short, business-like. You want to write this down?
No, I'll remember.
Well, if you don't, you're out. All right, tomorrow, 10:30 p.m., you talk to Raul, he'll show you around. And don't pick up any of his bad habits.
All right.
Let's go.
I don't understand why you're being so ungrateful about this.
Because it's just not that big a deal. It's a birthday party.
It's your birthday, and it was a big deal for me when I had you. You were large and painful, and since I happen to be financing this particular birthday party, it's my simple wish that no hobos be allowed.
White shirts, two, till starch. Afternoon, Mr. Dowling. Scarlett, this is Hank. Hank's the new doorman.
Hi, I'm Henry.
Welcome to the building, Hank. George, you did get my message about the caterer?
Yes, ma'am, sure did. I'll take care of Mrs. D.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Can I get those?
No, I'm okay, thank you.
There are plenty of people on the list. That we agree on
floor, please? The
penthouse. All right, we'll discuss it later. Hello. Oh, honey, it's Gretchen.
Should I just leave these here?
I'll take them all to Scarlett's room, down the hall, last door at the end, and this is for you, Harry.
Thank you.
See anything you like?
Oh, hey, your mom told me to put your bags in here.
And snoop through my stuff?
No, I wasn't snooping.
No, because it looked a little like snooping.
I should probably go.
Nice to meet you.
Classy ladies, make $5,000 a week without leaving your house. No experience necessary.
I don't think they want that one.
Why not?
Because they're looking for hookers.
Oh. Are you sure? Because it sounds pretty good.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Look, maybe I could get you a shift walking dogs, but it's not exactly a walk in the park.
Isn't it?
The fact that you think that makes me know that you are not ready.
Cashier, good starting pay, no experience necessary. How hard could that be?
Yeah, you know what? Call him, and don't let him jerk you around. You have got to be ready to play hardball.
Huh? No. No.
Oh, you got a real knack making oriental food. Wow. I'm gonna have a job. I haven't had one in 20 years.
They're gonna love you, Ma. It's gonna be great.
Just don't tell your brother. I don't want to argue with him.
I won't say anything.
Won't say anything about what?
What? Hey, how's school?
Great. Won't say anything about what?
I'm getting
a job.
No, you're not.
You listen to me. I'm your mother, and you can't tell me what I can't do. I'm not gonna just roll over and give up my house that I lived in for 15 years. We need money, and I'm getting a job.
No one's giving up the house, Ma. I left school today, and Uncle Colin got me a job as a doorman, so you don't have to go to work.
You quit school to take care of me?
I took a leave of absence.
You precious angel.
You gonna be a doorman?
What the hell's wrong with being a doorman?
You're gonna be able to tell me pretty soon.
Have a nice evening, Miss Chandler, okay? Hey, you. Come here. You must be the new kid.
Yeah, I'm your shape.
Raul, you're on with me tonight. Go get changed. Locker room's on B1, down the stairs. Make a right. Hurry up.
What the hell are you doing?
I'm Henry. I'm the new doorman.
What's going on?
I was sleeping. This guy was touching me.
Touching you?
I know. I wasn't touching him.
Was he touching you?
Okay, yes, I was touching him, but I thought something was wrong with his breathing. I was listening to his chest. I was on my way to get my uniform.
What's wrong with my chest?
Francesco, settle down, okay?
Look, buddy, I'm not gay.
Oh, who said anything about being gay?
He said I was touching him. I'm studying to be a nurse.
And you're not gay?
Look, Dr. Kildare, you're not working here. You're not on call, okay? If anything is wrong with him, you let him die. Now get a uniform, get dressed, and no touching. Don't touch anybody that works here. Don't touch anybody who lives here. You got it?
What's wrong with me?
You've got obstructed breathing.
What's destructive breathing?
Forget it. Do we really have to wear the hat?
Nice fit.
Thanks.
It's hot, right?
Yeah.
That's because it's made of wool. One uniform for summer, winter, spring, and fall. You ain't gonna find no air conditioner nowhere that's gonna stop you from sweating your nuts off.
Terrific.
You see Francisco downstairs?
Oh, yeah. We had a nice conversation.
Yeah? That's weird. He's usually asleep.
Time.
Look, I couldn't because, you know, waiting for you.
Oh, waiting for me.
Did you pack the BlackBerry charger?
Yes, I packed the BlackBerry charger. How many times are you going
to
ask me?
As many times as it takes to know you did it, Debbie.
Don't Debbie me!
Good evening, Mr. and Mrs. Silverman. Hey, Bobby. This is our new doorman, Henry.
Oh, hello, Henry.
Pleased to meet you, Henry.
Nice to meet you, too, sir.
Here, take Hercules. I need to take my Klonopin before we leave for this nightmare. I mean, our romantic anniversary getaway.
Car's ready, Mr. Silverman.
Thank you, Raul. We'll be back on Sunday. If you can't get us on the cell, you know you can always email. Your father doesn't even have a bowel movement without his BlackBerry.
No parties, Bobby.
Not gonna have any parties.
You listen to your father. I love you, sweetie.
You too, Mom.
Keep an eye on him, okay, Henry?
I will, sir. Thank you very much.
You hungry, man? I'm starving. Let's get something to eat.
I thought we weren't supposed to eat up here.
We ain't supposed to be seen eating. That don't mean we gotta starve. Yeah, what's happening? Let me get a, hold on one second. What you want?
You know what? It's my first night. I'm all right.
Sausage, pepperoni, what?
Sure.
Let me get a, large, half pepperoni, half sausage, 1500 Fifth Avenue. Yeah, what's up? It's Raul. Man, I'm just telling you know what's happening. Mm-hmm. Okay, thanks, for sure. 30 minutes or less. Nursing school, huh? I guess that's cool. You didn't want to be no doctor?
You know how much it costs to go to med school?
Nah.
More than I got. Crazy money. And I didn't have the scores for a scholarship.
I'm going to take off, buddy.
What do you mean take off?
You don't need me here, man. You got this job down pat. Somebody come, open the door, let them in. I mean, night shift is dead. It's easy. It's easier than being a nurse, right?
What if George comes?
George is asleep. And if he do come, just cover for me. Tell him I went to go get some coffee. Good looking, my brother.
Thank you.
Hi. Can I help you, ladies?
Yeah. We're here to see Roberto, AB, with his cousins.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Hang on one second. You said 8?
Yeah.
One second. Bobby? Bobby, is that you? Okay, Roberto, your cousins are here to see you. I'm sorry, what did you say your names were?
Mercedes and Portia.
Mercedes and Portia.
Yes, Cousin Mercedes.
You said you were his cousins?
Yeah, distant cousins. We moved a couple times. Are you gonna let us go up or what, baby?
Okay, go see your cousin. Sorry, didn't see you there.
Don't apologize. Help me.
Sure.
Henry, right?
Yeah.
Scarlett, stop flirting with the doorman and take Buck. Wanna go home?
Somebody have a little too much to drink?
Fuck you. I had exactly the right amount.
And puke and be an asshole all at the same time.
Oh, I think I'm gonna be sick.
No, sweetie, I'm sure you won't embarrass yourself. Thanks, Scratch. I'll take it from here. Something precious.
Yeah. I'm gonna go. Call you tomorrow.
Later, hot stuff.
Eat me.
Don't worry, I'll clean that up.
I'm not gonna let you clean up my boyfriend's puke.
He can clean it up. He's the doorman.
Stop being such a jerk.
Listen, don't worry about it. I clean up puke all the time. At school. I'm studying to be an... don't worry about it. I'll take care of it.
You're really sweet. Thank you. I owe you one.
Oh, fruit juice. Give him some fruit juice and some aspirin. It'll help his hangover.
Okay, great. Thanks.
Night shift is dead in my house.
Hey, you seen a couple of hoes coming here like 5 seconds ago?
Sir, if I could please ask you to wait outside.
Man, ring up the apartment and tell them I'm here like right this second. Or you need a tourniquet where your dick used to be and a feeding tube where your mouth used to be. Feel me?
Okay. Okay. Just give me 1 second. Bobby? You send those girls back down here immediately. Do it now or I will tell your father everything.
Fine, I'm coming.
He's coming. If I could just have you wait outside.
No, no. If they ain't down here soon, I'm going up.
Okay, you can just stay there.
You, Roberto, who got my money?
I don't have it. I thought I could use a credit card. Could I borrow a few bucks?
How much?
$200.
$200 for...
I'll totally pay you back.
$200. Here.
Still short, man. Who wants my money?
Look, there's 196 there. You gonna hurt this kid over $4?
It's your lucky day, Roberto.
Are you nuts?
I'm sorry. I'll pay you back. With interest. Just don't tell my folks.
Don't. Go to bed.
You're gonna tell, aren't you?
No, I'm gonna finish mopping up this puke, and you're gonna pay me back tomorrow. Okay? I don't live on Fifth Avenue. $200 is a lot of money to me.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. I owe you one.
You owe me 201. Go to bed before I change my mind. Hey, George, I was just adjusting my back.
Walt, he was sleeping.
All right, I'm sorry.
Kid, you can't sleep in the lobby. You got to get used to the night shift. Don't let it happen again.
All right.
Where's Raul?
He's here.
Where?
He was here.
Here, where?
I was just out getting coffee. You want one?
No.
This one's on me.
Nice. How did you...
Look, man, I've been working here for 8 years. I pick up on habits. That man right there, George, he's a creature of habit.
Ugh, what is that?
Aged coffee. Keep your head outside behind the bushes. So, hey, partner. Right on time, baby.
Like that. I know damn well you started it. You know, here. Get over yourself.
What's with the dogs, Kate?
They're normally really well behaved, but Stella can be a little bitch.
No, I mean, why are they here?
Oh, that. I'm making some extra cash to an overnight boarder.
So we're running a kennel now?
Mom is fine with it as long as they keep quiet.
They're not quiet.
By dog standards, they are church mice. You don't forget it. You don't know anything about dogs.
Okay, where's Ma?
I think she got a job.
Great.
It's so sensitive, that one.
Welcome back.
Thanks.
You have here a letter or something. One night, and he has a secret admirer. That's it for me. I have sucked enough ass for one day. Have a good night, Henry.
All right, you too.
I can sing better than you, and that's why you don't like it.
Okay, let me tell you something. It's heartache tonight. Not party tonight. It's not a happy song, Ray.
Why can't you just admit when you don't know something except talking out of your hoop? Why?
Ring, hello, clue phone. It's for you. It's the Eagles calling to say you're an idiot.
Oh, like the Eagles would call you, Mr. Wrapped Up Like a Douche?
Oh, please. Everyone thinks it's a douche at 9 years old.
I think you're a douche. Can you help us? Do you know that song?
Let It Go, Ray. I'll buy you the CD for Rosh Hashanah.
Oh, no. Your dog.
No, it's the Eagles.
No, your dog is going up in the elevator with the leash.
Oh, my God, Kathy!
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Cassius!
Oh my God, he's making noise.
Cassius, everything's gonna be fine, breathe! It's all your fault. You weren't so in love with Glenn Frost.
Oh, shut up, shut up!
Yeah, I'm sure he'll be fine.
Oh my God.
He's dead. Oh my God, he's dead. You killed him! Oh my God, what's he doing?
Oh my God, he's reviving. Oh, hang in there, Cassius, hang in, baby. Hang in, don't go in the light.
Sorry. No, I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. You, mister, who's amazing. You are.
Thank you so much. I mean, I don't know how we could ever repay you. Don't worry, I'm just doing my job. Oh, sort of.
Come here.
I can, you don't need. Thank you so much.
The mouth? Gross to mouth.
Thank you.
Hi, Scarlett.
Wow. I've never seen anyone do that before.
Yeah, that was my first time with a dog. That didn't sound right.
No, it didn't.
What was that?
What?
What'd I tell you about getting too personal with the residents?
It wasn't a resident, sir. It was a dog, and he was gonna die.
Not the dog, wise guy. Miss Dowling.
Oh.
You don't listen to a bit, do you? What are you standing for? Get to the station. I didn't know you could do that to a dog.
Yeah, man, because you know, so... Yeah, like I was saying, you know, I'm trying to do my thing.
I'll take those up. Sorry. Tennis not home. I'll sign for him. Someone get that.
Would you get that?
Nothing would give me more pleasure. Thank you so much.
Flowers, darling.
Don't forget the tip.
Getting him a tip.
This for me?
Yeah, I think so.
Right, this way, please.
I think they're from your friend Buck.
Yeah, I
figured. All done and dusted.
You can just move some of that crap away.
Your room is great.
Isn't it? I wish it didn't make me so sick.
Why? What's wrong with it?
I didn't decorate it. Mother.
Mm.
You have a little orange something on your nose.
Orange stuff?
Yeah, it's like powder or something. There you go.
Thanks.
Henry?
Yeah?
How did you know how to save that dog last night? What, do you like a vet or something?
Oh, no. I was never in the military. I'm a nurse. I'm almost a nurse.
So you're an almost nurse slash doorman?
Yeah. Well, I'm still in school.
Oh.
Yeah. I had to take some time off to help,
Hey, there you are.
Buck, don't you have a phone?
Nice flowers, man.
Yeah, glad you approve. Don't tell me you're mad about last night. I think those cocktail olives are bad, because I didn't have that much to drink.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they're lucky I don't have soup. Listen, I'm gonna make a drink. And you change, put something nice on.
Okay.
And we'll go.
You go do that. Bye.
Hey, Grace. Looking good. I got your green tea chai latte. I took the liberty of putting in a phytonutrient tablet. Now, it's got some powerful antioxidants. Give you a boost.
Well, that's very sweet. Thank you, Laszlo.
Are you happy?
Very happy. This chair is really comfortable.
It's one of our best sellers. It comes with a how-to video that's amazing. Well, I'm glad that you're happy. Because if you're happy, the workplace is happy, the customers are happy, and then I'm happy. I'm a people person. At least I try very hard to be.
Well, I love people. And I really like working here already.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, geez, I love to hear that. And you're doing a great job. Keep it up.
Okay, you too.
I do.
Thank you for my Fido.
We were in Japan was in 95, and
no, no, that was Hong Kong. We were in Japan in 98.
Absolutely. We were in Hong Kong.
Yes.
We were invited to see a Japanese production of Cats, which, let me tell you, was better than the original.
All right, can we go in, please?
Dude, you killed it.
Did I? Sorry, buddy. Hey, thanks for doing your job. Appreciate it.
Sorry about that, guys.
Whatever. We went swimming in a lake, and I don't know if you know that these little fish, I forgot the name of them, but when you urinate in water, they fly up the stream the other way.
Hello, Mrs. Dowling.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you. I wouldn't miss it for the world. Hey, you look great.
Oh, well, thank you.
I mean that.
Thank you.
Great. Boy, oh boy. I did mean that.
Your boyfriend's already completely loaded.
Welcome to my life. I don't know why I put up with it.
Because good-looking and rich is a rare commodity.
Seriously. Oh, God, I'm not a bachelor, am I?
No, of course not. But a helicopter to the Hamptons every weekend doesn't necessarily mean you're shallow. No, I mean, who wants to do that drive, especially in summer? Are you okay?
Everybody, could I have your attention? Thank you. Now, if the birthday girl could join me. You know, I can hardly believe that this girl whose diaper I changed, who I taught to ride a bike, and who I can still hear reciting the lines of Puck from the Immortal Bard in fourth grade, has transformed into this beautiful, graceful, and sophisticated young woman. Scarlett, I know that I speak on behalf of your mother and myself when I say that we genuinely could not have asked for a better child.
Thanks, Dad.
Happy birthday, sweetheart. Happy 21st, Scarlett. Oh, I nearly forgot. Small token of our affection.
Great. No. Oh, my God! Thank you!
Hi, this is my boy. Okay.
So, I need another drink. A whiskey and Coke. Could you get that for me, please? Oh.
Happy birthday, baby. Give me that.
Here. Hey, anyway,
hey.
So...
Hey. We need to talk.
Okay, here.
This party sucks.
Do the right thing.
Gracias, amigo.
Dude,
that's our baby picture.
Whatever.
Right.
Holy shit.
What? That's a lot of weight, bro.
Would you stop being such a pussy, Jake?
We'll split it. Are you gonna do all mine too? Come on, man. Hey. Yeah. Thanks. So good.
I want a white one, Mr. Dowling.
A ribbon?
A car still.
Oh, no problem. When do you need it by?
Let's walk. He's passed out on the floor in the bathroom.
Oh my God. What happened?
I don't know. He fell and then.
Jake, tell me what happened.
We were doing some boil, all right? Scarlett, he did too much.
Call 911. Somebody call 911!
What's going on? Isn't there a doctor here?
Dr. Rosenthal and his wife RSVP'd, but they never showed up.
Mother, call Henry downstairs. He's a nurse.
Henry the doorman?
Yes, just do it!
Front desk, Raul. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Okay, I'll send him up right now. Henry, 911 to the Downs apartment. Somebody's hurt.
What's going on?
I don't know. Come on! Get in there.
Excuse me. What happened?
He was doing coke. I don't think he's breathing.
Jesus,
he
did a ton.
Okay.
Come on, you stupid prick. Breathe.
Is that CPR?
Come on, man. He's trying glue.
Okay, this isn't working.
Oh, my God.
Okay, I'm going to have to ask everybody to back up. Can I have you guys back up? I'm going to try something.
Are you okay? Oh.
Cocaine OD?
Yeah.
I tried to give him CPR, but it didn't work.
So you hit him with a precordial thump?
Uh-huh.
Nice work.
Thanks.
We'll take it from here. You're lucky you're not dead, kid. Not too many people know how to do the thump.
You okay?
Yeah.
Are you sure, man? Because you don't look okay.
I'm so freaked out. I just saved a guy's life.
No shit, who?
Yeah, Scarlett's boyfriend.
Wow.
You saved my friend's life, man. I want to thank you. I got $200 on me. I wish I had more, but...
$200, that's cool, baby.
No, I don't have a check.
Make it out to Henry O'Shea. You do know how to spell O'Shea, don't you?
O'Shea?
Yeah.
No. I'm not taking a tip for saving a guy's life.
If you'd like, you can make it out to Raul.
Raul?
Yeah, R-A-U.
Look, you already thanked me. That's fine. Are you serious? Thank you.
Kid, let me explain something to you. You cannot turn down a $200 tip, man.
I'm not taking a tip for saving a guy's life. It's not right.
We'll give it to your crew. We didn't save nobody's life.
Hi.
Hey.
You were amazing. I don't know how to thank you.
You don't have to, really.
You saved his life. I mean, even the paramedics said so.
I've never done that before. I mean, we practiced in school, but someone was about to die. It's kind of scary.
You didn't look scared.
No?
No, you looked like you were totally in control of the situation. Kind of like when you had the dog's head in your mouth. It's kind of hot.
Very funny.
You're a sweet guy, Henry. I gotta go.
Night, Ms. Dowling.
You got a real problem with keeping your hands to yourself.
Come on, George. She was upset. I was comforting her.
This is your last warning. Next time, if I hear or see you touching anybody in this building, you hit the bricks. And that goes for dogs, too.
You're a sweet guy, Henry. What am I doing, man? Do you have girl trouble often?
Raul's a love doctor.
Then fix me, doctor. Fix me.
Let it go, papito.
So how's the dorm in business?
It's definitely been a lesson in humility.
Any good stories yet?
None that don't make me seem ridiculous.
What kind of stories do you think I like?
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah, shoot. Yep. Yep. Hey.
Did you date a guy who was dirt poor?
No.
Okay.
I'm just pulling a leash. Of course. Hey, get over yourself. Girls don't care about money, not the good ones anyway. Girls just want you to be the alpha. You know, you'd be strong and assertive, you'll have to beat them off with a stick.
You want a guy to be the alpha?
Me? Hell no. Wait a second, why are we talking about this? Who's the girl?
No, I mean, there's no girl.
Hank, you're lying to me. You're a terrible liar. What's her name?
When would I have had time to meet a girl?
I don't know. She lives in the building. She lives in the building. What's her name?
You're good.
What's her name?
Scarlett. Scarlett Dowling.
Scarlett Dowling?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good luck. What, is she some kind of high-maintenance trust fund kid or something?
I don't know, probably.
You asked her out yet?
No, of course not.
Why not?
Because rich girls from Fifth Avenue don't date their doormen. Plus, I would get fired.
Mm-hmm. Yep, that would be bad.
Hello, Ms. Dowling.
Henry, please don't call me that. Scarlett.
Scarlett. How's Buck doing?
Rehab.
Well, I guess that's a good thing.
It is. Listen, Henry, I think I figured out how I want to thank you. I want to take you somewhere.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, and it's a surprise.
I'm going to bring those up as soon as they arrive, Ms. Dowling.
Hi, George.
Hello, Scarlett.
George, did you know that Henry here is the best doorman that we've ever had?
Oh, yeah. Henry's, he's got a real way with the residents. You keep it up, Henry. Keep it up.
Okay, so what is with the tape?
I don't know. Yeah, it's been one of the great mysteries of the building. I don't think anyone's been able to ask him.
I'm not asking him.
So, you'll come?
Yeah, I don't think that's such a good idea. They don't like us getting too friendly with the residents, and I'm pretty sure George would fire me. I can't afford that right now.
Okay, so we won't go out. We'll have a meeting.
A meeting?
Yes, a meeting. And it starts tomorrow at 7 p.m.
Pier 83 on the West Side Highway.
When's the word?
Scarlett, I can't.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't. I really want to, but I can't.
You said Pier 83?
Mm-hmm.
At 7?
Yes.
Okay. Sounds like a good place for a meeting.
Meeting?
It's just a meeting.
Hi. I'm so sorry. You weren't waiting long, were you?
No.
Okay, I couldn't find a cab, and I was just... What?
No, nothing.
Why are you looking at me like
that? You look great.
Thank you.
I look like a Mormon missionary.
You look great. Well, maybe we should...
Yeah.
Go.
I didn't know where we were going. How about a hint?
A hint. Well, let's see. It's bigger than a red box, and it floats.
Hi, two tickets, please.
Oh, no, I've got this.
No, don't be silly. I have seat here.
No, I insist. I wasn't raised like that. Two, please.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Your card's declined.
What?
Is there another one?
That can't be right.
You want me to try it again?
No, I have cash. I was supposed to pay anyway. Your machine must be broken.
Yeah, my machine's broken.
Sorry about that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
How can I help you?
You should have listened to what Mama said and walked away with someone else instead. Should have listened to what Grandma said and married someone more like Fred.
May I ask you something?
Sure.
Why be a doorman? I thought you were studying to be a nurse.
My Uncle Colin, he's been a doorman forever. He got me the job.
But why a doorman? I mean, no offense. I thought you might do something in the medical field. It just seems...
What? Beneath me?
No. Not that.
I'm not really a nursing school. I mean, I was, but, my dad died. And, his life insurance... Well, whatever, it's complicated. But my mom was left with a lot of debt. So, I just had to get a job fast.
I'm really sorry. I didn't know that.
It's all right. Wow. She's amazing.
They tried to make me jealous.
You two are so different. You really shouldn't compare yourself. I mean, she's so much bigger and greener.
Maybe you're right. Give me your tired, your poor... What is it?
Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free. Send these. Homeless, tempest tossed to me. I lift my lamp beside the golden door.
Now you're just showing off.
Not really. It's one of the only poems I remember. Emma Lazarus. I had to memorize it in, like, seventh grade.
She wasn't wearing anything under the dress. Well, of course she's too old. Mm-hmm. Well, just because she left him, I don't see why she has to completely lose control. Ellen? Ellen, I have to call you back. Yes, this is Mrs. Dowling. I need to speak with George.
Hey, George. You wanted to see me?
I'm gonna get right to the point. Did you or did you not go on a date with Scarlett Downey.
Well, I didn't go on a date.
Don't lie to me, kid. The mother is fit to be tied.
George, it wasn't a date, all right? It was a meeting.
Don't sass me. I hate to be sassed.
Okay, just listen to me for a sec. I can totally explain. Her boyfriend or her ex-boyfriend or whatever, Buck, OD'd in the apartment, right? And they asked me up, and I went up there, and I saved the kid. I saved him in the apartment, and she asked me out to thank me.
What?
You got a tattoo on your face. A face tattoo.
All right, that's it. You're fine. Get up.
Look, George, listen to me, please. I really need this job.
Yeah, well, you should have thought about that when you dated him, Romeo. You knew the rules, you broke the rules, you're out. And don't use the front. Use the service elevator.
Hi, is Scarlett there? This is the front desk calling.
Oh, what the hell are you doing? Get out of here! I'm calling your uncle!
Hi, Raul. Can I leave this with you? It's for Henry. It's just a letter.
Maybe I should call George.
No, it's for Henry.
I think you should call George.
Okay. I'll give it to him myself.
You got fired.
Yeah, I did. Thanks for being discreet.
Sorry. Why'd they can ya?
Super found out that I went on a date with Scarlett.
You got fired over a girl. Do you have any idea how cool that is? I wish somebody would get fired for me.
Yeah, well, it's not gonna be so cool when we lose the house. Dad's gone. No one's gonna take care of this for us. What am I supposed to do if I can't find another job?
Look, you're smart. Okay, you got all your teeth. Sorry. Anyway, look, forget about the job, all right? Jobs grow on trees. What are you gonna do about the girl?
I'm not gonna do anything about the girl. It was her family that got me fired. Mm. Whatever. I'm always gonna be a doorman to those people.
Well, looks like you don't have to worry about being the doorman anymore, so that's solved. And besides, I'm not gonna lose the house. Mom got a great job.
She did.
Apparently purple is the color this season.
Damn it, Mother, I'm serious.
No, so am I. Look at these pictures. I look awful in purple.
What did you do to Henry?
I had him fired.
Why would you do that?
You can't date the help, Scarlett. It doesn't look good.
Henry is not the help, Mother. He's a human being.
All right, fine, he's a human being. But, sweetheart, a doorman? Why on earth would you date a doorman? How do you think that makes me feel? Meredith Dowling's daughter's going out with their doorman. I just hope no one saw you together.
I had no idea what an elitist snob you are.
Don't talk to me that way. And don't be so dramatic. I just want what's best for you.
No, you just want what's best for you. I'm gonna date whoever I want. Okay? Whether it's the doorman, the trash man, or the mayor. And it's gonna have nothing to do with their station in life, but everything to do with who they are.
Oh, Miss Dowling. What a pleasant surprise.
Yeah, can it, George. Hire him back.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. There are strict rules about fraternization.
Okay, well, give me his number.
I'm sorry, I can't do that either. I really am sorry.
Fine, be a jerk. I mean, I can get his number. You don't think I can get his number? I can get it. 76 Henry O'Shea's? You're kidding, right?
No, ma'am, I don't yet.
No, I guess you don't. Okay. Okay, give them to me.
I can only give you two numbers at a time.
Whoa. Can I help you?
Yeah, I want to talk to Scarlett Darling.
You're going to have to wait outside. We cannot have all these animals in our lobby.
Would you just get it down here? These dogs crap on command, and they eat uncooperative doormen. Just get it down here.
Are you a friend?
What's your name?
Raul.
Raul? I'm Kate. I'm Henry's sister. So would you just be a sport and call up for me? I mean it.
Yeah, it's Raul from downstairs. Some lady
down
there.
Not today.
Yeah, sister.
Okay.
She'll be right down. So you're Hank's sister?
Yeah.
He didn't tell me you had a sister. Listen, I think that's bullshit what happened to Hank. We kind of miss him.
That's cute. But Hank needs to go back to school. Maybe this will make that happen.
Why'd he leave anyway?
Our dad died.
Wow. Sorry to hear that. I lost one of my dads, too.
I'm sorry. So, yeah, that's why Hank dropped out.
That's messed up.
Hi. You're Henry's sister?
Yeah, Kate.
Scarlett.
You want to take a walk?
I would love to.
Excellent.
Well, nice to meet you.
Do you need that hand?
I got it.
I feel really bad about what happened to Henry. I mean, he told me he was going to get fired, and I insisted. It's my fault.
Pardon me for saying, but that is bullshit. Hank got fired because of Hank, not because of you. Not because of your mother, although she sounds colorful. I heard about that. He got fired because of him, whatever he did.
I still feel awful.
Hank will get another job. I'm just happy to hear that you feel awful.
You know, I think I can help him get his job back.
Maybe you shouldn't.
You don't think he wants my help?
No, isn't that? Oh, easy. Easy. Okay. Isn't that? It's just, you know, Hank needs to be back in school.
You're right. He's too smart to be a doorman.
No, he's not. It's just that he wants to be a nurse. What's wrong with being a doorman?
No, nothing. Nothing's wrong with being a doorman. I just think it's a misuse of Henry's talents.
We agree about that. Come on.
No way. This can't be it.
She told me that I was going on a trip, and that I was going to meet some tall, dark stranger.
What are you looking at?
You need help finding something? Grand Theft Anal, Section 4 Male Erotic. Henry! What a nice surprise.
What are you doing here?
I'm working.
No, you don't work here. This is a sick, sick place for sick perverted
shit. It's a video store, honey, for dykes.
Okay, we need to talk. Outside.
I'm working. Don't you need to get to work?
Hey, Gracie. Great job on the dildo display.
Thank you, Laszlo. I would like you to meet my son, Henry.
Hey, it's a great pleasure.
Yeah, that's... Sure, great. Look, I'm sorry to tell you that my mother needs to resign from your store.
Really? I mean, but she's employee of the week. Hey, Henry, what do you do?
I'm a nurse.
Ooh, well, to each his own. You know, when the customers come in here and they figure out that Gracie is working here, well, it makes them more relaxed. They feel like they're at home because maybe their mothers didn't appreciate these kinds of things, so she's great for business.
Isn't he sweet?
I only wish that my mother were more like her. Hot and totally non-judgmental.
Okay, that's great. Thank you. We need to go.
Henry, no. I'm not quitting. I'm treated with respect here, and I like it.
All right. How would you like to be assistant manager? Would you like that? $2 more an hour? All
yes.
Right, you're assistant manager. Hey, nice meeting you.
No.
You cannot work here anymore. You need to go and tell him that you quit.
You are really bothering me. I'm working.
I'm serious. You're fine.
Shh. Henry?
Oh, no. No. Scarlett, you can't be here. Not here.
Yeah, baby, you're right there.
Don't look at that.
Yeah, baby, look at it. Yeah, now spit on it.
Need help finding something, sweetie?
Scarlett, this is my mother, Grace.
Hi, it's nice to meet you.
Well, very nice to meet you, too. Are you looking for an adult film?
No, I was looking for Henry.
God damn, it's hot in here.
Yeah.
No. What the hell are you doing?
I thought that... Forget it.
I'm not supposed to wear this uniform in here.
I won't tell if you're not.
Yeah. What are you doing here?
Kate said you might be here.
To talk to Kate?
Yeah, she came by the building. Which I'm glad she did because I was having a hell of a time finding your number.
Were you?
I wanted to say I was really sorry. Yeah, it's my fault that you got fired and I really want to fix it.
You got fired?
Yeah. I'm sorry, Ma. I was going to tell you.
Sorry about what? Everybody gets fired. Yeah, maybe right there, except right here. With Laszlo.
Let's talk inside.
Okay. I can help you find another job. My father knows a lot of people.
Look, I'll find something, okay? It's really not your problem.
I want to help. I mean, it's the least I can do. My dad has
a
friend.
All right? I don't need your help, and I don't need your dad's help. I can take care of myself and my family.
Fine. You don't have to be such a jerk about it.
I'm not being a jerk, though.
Yeah, you kind of are.
Okay, what are we doing here?
Fighting about you being a jerk?
Seriously.
Henry, I like you. You know, I really want to see you again.
I'm sure your mom would love that. Look, I don't know what a guy like me can possibly hope to offer someone like you. I mean, I can't put $100 on a credit card, much less take you out to dinner anywhere but a hot dog stand.
I like hot dogs. I don't really care about that stuff.
Yeah, well, I do. And you can't possibly know what that feels like. I mean, you're Fifth Avenue, and I'm always gonna be Flatbush, right? I couldn't keep up. You know, there's a reason that people don't date their doormen.
Maybe you're right. Have a nice life, Henry O'Shea. Did she find you? Hey. Home guy. Is Carla find you?
Yeah, she just left.
Hi, honey.
Oh, hey.
Hi.
Hey, did your friend leave?
Yeah, how'd it go? She's got beautiful bone structure.
Okay, oh. I don't want to talk about it.
Okay, you know what? I didn't pay $14 for a cab, so I don't want to talk about it, so start talking.
What? What happened?
I don't want to talk about it.
Okay. So Henry's really into this rich girl at his building, right? So finally she asks him out, whatever, and then he gets fired.
For dipping your penis in the company ink.
Ma, don't talk about my penis.
I just learned that expression. I like it.
I don't think that's the exact same.
So that was her in the store. Where'd she go?
I don't know. She's gone. It was never gonna work out. They're millionaires. I mean, they've got a car and a driver and a house in the Hamptons. They got a Jamaican lady who lives in their apartment and cooks for them. I thought she was the maid too, but it turns out they got another lady for that. I mean, I was in their living room the other night, and above their fireplace, they have a Cezanne. Not like a poster, like a real Cezanne. I mean, these people live on a different planet. They don't want me dating their daughter. You know, I mean, what, at best, I'm gonna be a nurse? My dad wasn't a master of the universe, he was a plumber. My mom works in a porn shop, my sister's a dog walker. These two worlds don't mix.
Are you done?
Yeah, I guess.
You're done insulting yourself and your family? You're done labeling the entire world? I don't care if you date this girl or not, but you don't define your father as a plumber, or your sister as a dog walker, or yourself as a nurse. Your father loved people. He loved his family. Yeah, he loved handball a little too much. But he was a kind, compassionate man who would have given the shirt off his back to anybody. There's no girl that's too good for my Henry. I don't care how rich or pretty she is, she'd be lucky to be loved by you.
I'm gonna go.
Yeah, I'm gonna go sell some lubricants. I'll see you later. Hank!
Thank you.
Yo, Henry. Yo, I don't want to sound like a dick, but George says you ain't allowed in this building no more.
Raul, I just need you to call Scarlett.
She's not here.
Oh, come on, Raul. Can't you just call her for me, please?
I'm telling you, man, she's not here, for real. They just left, the whole family.
Well, do you know where they were going?
I think they went to the Gotham Club. Your sister was here, too. She told me about your dad. Sorry, buddy. If there's anything that we can, you know...
Where is it? The Gotham place. Do you know where it is?
It's on Park and 55th.
Park and 55th. Thanks, man.
Hold on, man. You can't get in wearing that bullshit.
So, what's your rush?
I think I really like this girl and I might have blown it.
Not so fast, Hotshot. Let me tell you something about women. Never to be trusted for a second. I once had a huge property. Swimming pool, tennis court, waterfall. It's like heaven on earth, man. And this Svengali bitch took me for everything.
Sorry to hear that, Rajib.
Let me tell you something, kiddo. Run. Run like Seabiscuit, okay? And don't look back. Never look back. Here we are, Tiger. That will be $9.75.
Thanks for the advice.
Anytime. $9.75, $10, 25 cent dip. Now I can retire. Cheap bastard.
May I help you, sir?
Yeah, I'm here to see Scarlett Dowling. I think she's here already.
Well, sir, if you're meeting the Dowlings, you cannot come into the club without the correct attire. Coat and tie. No jeans, no sneakers.
Look, I don't suppose that you just let me run up there and give her a message quickly.
I'm afraid not.
How about this? I'll let you hold my ID.
Sir, this isn't a nightclub.
No, right. I like your work. Hey, boys. It's another night on the job. Waiting. Taking my break, guys.
I cannot believe he ordered the fettuccine alfredo, which is not
Henry?
I need to talk to you.
Couldn't you have just called?
I'm sorry to barge in on you like this, Miss Dowling, but I really need to talk to Scarlett. Can I borrow her for a second?
Did you get dressed as a chef just to get in here?
Yes, sir, I did.
I like it. You're the chap who saved Buck, aren't you?
The doorman, Philip.
Is there a problem, Mrs. Dowling?
Mother, don't. I don't believe this man belongs in the club.
I'm so sorry, Mrs. Dowling. Sir, you need to leave.
Wait a second. Scarlett, hear me out. And if you don't ever want to talk to me again, that's fine. But what I said before was bullshit. I don't care that you're Fifth Avenue and that I'm Flatbush. It doesn't matter. I haven't stopped thinking about you since that first time I saw you getting out of the elevator. And you know what? I don't care who knows it or what anybody else thinks. And maybe I'll never be rich. And maybe I'll never be a member of a fancy club. But none of that matters to me.
Oh, that's very touching.
Come on, let's go.
Let go of him. Mother, I'm leaving with Henry. Scarlett, you will do nothing of the sort. Come back here and sit down. Why, Mother? Because you're afraid I'm going to embarrass you? Look, everyone. Meredith Dowling's daughter is leaving with the doorman. Don't worry. He's not a doorman anymore. Mother had him fired.
Scarlett, come back here.
Meredith, be quiet. Let them be.
Scarlett.
Henry, how are you?
Not too bad. How are you doing, Buck?
Just trying to stay sober. Every day's a struggle.
Nice to see you, Buck. We were just leaving.
Okay.
Gretchen, you're a hooker.
Oh. Hey, you're not a hooker. Come on.
Promise?
Yeah.
Well, that went well. Gotta get hesitate.
person. You don't understand what I say.
She sure is beautiful.
Oh, thanks, baby.
No, fool, I was talking about Lady Liberty. Mm. Not that you're not beautiful at all. It's just, you know, being up under her torch, she sort of makes us all feel equal. Mm. Black or white, rich or poor, Mets or Yankees.
Jets or Giants?
Knicks or Nets?
Rangers or Islanders?
Nice.
Broadway or peep shows?
Broadway or peep shows?
Lower East or Crown Heights? That's my thing.
Queen of the concrete.
Cab or subway?
With heels on your small feet. Your head at an angle. Like you know something, think like you know something. And the car takes a right turn, it rolls to a slow burn. And you start shaking, because just what you do, do is just what you do. Little hula girl, you look tall in the world. With your swing around hips, in a grass skirt swirl. Oh, little hula girl, you're like a plastic pearl. You know we're all spinning around you, on a tilted world. Sound, you never make a sound. Does it ever get you down, down? Does it ever get you down?
You know it when you wake up. Put on your shirt and go out. You should know the way by heart. Now we hardly even know it when it's gone. The days that it struck you. Still to breathe.